what is 2010 for me? 2010, I would say it's been one of my biggest years. It's been one of my most travel years. It's, wow, it's been a lot of things, you know. I guess that's the only way to put it. It's been a lot of things. Hey, was definitely a massive record. Unexpected, quite honestly, it was unexpected record. I'm just glad it, you know, glad it happened, you know. Making records is just like, you know, the lottery, you know. It's just, that's what it is, it's just a lottery. I just make them, so I don't know whether it's gonna be a bomb, I don't know whether it's gonna be a flop. I just make what comes from my heart, you know. So sometimes you're right, sometimes you're wrong, you know. You never know. For me, it's just making something that that you can connect to me with. That's how I felt, you know. You know, that's how I felt when I was younger, and I would meet a girl or something like that. Or, you know, it's I heard you say, hey, it's based upon what I think a girl would go through. You know, I mean, I heard you say, hey, you know. My life was completely okay till you came into my life and you wrecked it. You know, that's hey.
Because I walked your way, and I heard you say, I heard you say, and I heard you say, I heard you say, and I heard you say, I heard you say, I heard you say, I heard you say.
But in 2011, honestly, I have no idea what the hell I'm going to do. I could sit here and try to tell you, yeah, I'm going to do this record, do that record. I don't know. You know, I just make what I feel is right at that moment, you know. And right now I'm feeling, you know, I think I need something kind of like deep and nasty, you know. Yeah, the airport. Wow. Well, it used to be underground is my home. Now the airport is my home. I'm a geek. I'm a techno geek, you know. I love techie stuff. Not music. I mean, you know, like gadgets and you know, my programs, you know, as far as making music. I'm just a geek, man. I think that's great. I think that, you know, the internet has been a boon for us, you know. The social media outlets have been amazing, you know. Networking, amazing. It's people complain about it as it not being the same as, you know, when it was vinyl. But at the same time, you wouldn't have had the exposure that you have today back then without these networking outlets. One can complain, but I'm not into complaining. You know, my favorite saying is keep it moving. You know, just keep it moving. Before Rapid Share, before that we had cassettes. You know, everybody copied records on cassettes. Look, when you want a record and you like it a lot, you'll pay for it. You know, if there's an album you want, you'll pay for it. If you do, yeah, I mean, I buy stuff because I want it. You know, I see it, I hear it, I say, okay, I want that record. I'm not gonna spend, I'd rather not spend 2 hours looking for it on Rapid Share than spending 99 cents, okay? Let's be realistic. It's gonna cost me more time than the 99 cents I'm paying for that record. So come on, don't be cheap bastards, okay? Honestly, a dreamy holiday. Home. Home. Yeah. There it is. Home. Yo, what's up? This is Dennis Ferrer, and you're watching DanceSignal.com. Keep it where it's at, y'all.